So in today's video, I'm going to be going over part two of the husky eye. I'm going to be showing you how I did the fur around the eye and how you can get a somewhat of a realistic look, I think, with just a little bit of color. Didn't use a lot of color here, but I hope you enjoy the video, and if you did, or if you do, please leave a like down low, and I hope you enjoy. Going in with ivory, putting it down just in some areas here. That I think. Need an ivory color, especially up here. Where is my stick tag? Alrighty, now going in with my beige red. Doing a flicking motion. Rotating my pencil whenever I pick it up. Just a tad bit to this area, and going up into this area here, touch of it here, and here. Sweet. Cold gray one is going to be my base color. Goes around here as well. And here like so. And get rid of these pencil lines a little bit. So here, white white fur is a little bit more difficult to do than darker colors, because you really need to put down the shadows in the correct areas, so that way the lighter spots look white. A lot of people just assume that white is just white, but there's actually dark tones and light tones in that fur. The fur is also reflecting any of the colors that is surrounding the animal. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go kind of lighten up the pencil lines again, going in with ivory first. And even a little bit here. Cool beans. Going in with beige red again. Whenever I'm not drawing, I'm actually kind of leaning back, thinking about my next color, and also looking at the reference photo just to make sure that I get the correct color next. So right now I'm thinking about my next color, and it's looking like a warm gray one. This will help darken the cold gray one in a few areas. That should have a little bit more of shadows in them to give the eye more of a 3D look. So like here, for example, darker because there is a shadow here. I'm just gonna bring it down. So right here it kind of does an upwards curve where it's gonna meet this downwards I go right into this black patch of fur, and it's gonna come up again, down again, up again, down again. I actually have a tutorial on how I draw white fur, so if you struggle with that, then please go and check that video out. I also believe I have two other fur tutorials. I believe one is for black fur and the other one is for calico fur. The calico fur, I took a picture of my own cat as a reference photo. So that was a lot of fun to do and fun to create. So if you could go check those out, that would be lovely. So I didn't plan on doing it this way, but I'm actually now recording on my phone because OBS didn't like my original video that I was videotaping at the same time as this one. So the ending is all jumpy and just not professional looking. So until I get that sorted, I figured I would do the rest of this eye tutorial on my phone. That way I can do a YouTube video, but also fun videos for TikTok. I do have a TikTok account, so please go and check me out over there as well. And you know what? I have an Instagram. I'm going to plug myself right now. I have an Instagram. I have Etsy, which I really need to update. I have Facebook. I do have a Twitch account. Haven't used that in a while. I kind of fell out of touch with going live on there. And I'm hoping I get a little bit more practice in doing videos this way. So maybe I can do live videos on my other accounts, like maybe a live on Instagram, live on TikTok, maybe even over on Facebook. That'd be fun. I do have a full-time job too, so I gotta plan everything around my full-time job. So right now I'm taking this warm gray and I'm actually going to just put it down in this, like it's kind of like a peppery black. It's not solid black, it's more of a peppery black. I'm going to take this beige red and just kind of put that down on top. Sorry, I've got a... My nose started running while recording this video. Sorry for all the sniffles. Here as well. A little bit more up here, I think. Warm gray 2 next. Let's see. Where can this color help me? We're gonna do it here. Flicking up motion. Just kind of darken it up right here a bit. of darken it up slightly here too. And here as well. Fun, fun. Down here. Alrighty, and we're gonna go up here. We're going in the direction of the fur that I can see in the reference photo. So here it kind of swoops down and up, like a funny looking check mark almost. Same here, and then it kind of bumps together where the nose meets the eye, and that goes like that. Bring this up a bit and bring it down. So right here, it's a little bit of a dark patch. So we'll put the shading down first before going in my darker colors to add more of the defined details that I can see. Same here. I'm just kind of bringing the warm gray 2 into this color a bit. And we're going to do here as well, where it flicks up and over and down into here. Excuse me. And move right here as well. I know where the pencil lines that I can still see are gonna actually be darker in color. Definitely darker in color. And up here it kind of flicks up. Really trying not to say nothing too crazy. I noticed I said that a lot in the first video. I hope you counted how many times I said that. Be funny if someone did. Nothing like practice makes perfect, right, you guys? Just kind of talking to myself while doing this. I'm sure people think I am crazy if they're watching me from the outside world. My parents upstairs can hear me talking to myself and they're laughing at what I'm saying. Alrighty. Okay. I think potentially I'm done with that color. I think. What color is this? Cold gray 2. I'm gonna actually add that into the nose here. And right here as well. It's more of a blue tone to it. So. It's actually a little bit of a blue tint in this dark area of fur here as well. So we'll get that put down. Just like that. Kind of swoops down and around here as well. This area. Okay, I'm darkening up some areas up here with this color. Sure, it'll help a tad bit. And right here too. So I've kind of like left this area here untouched for now. It is a lot more white. You can see a lot of the reflection up there, so I don't want to put too much detail there for now. I'll go in a little bit with my warm gray 1 and cold gray 1 afterwards, just to get a little bit of a fur detail in there. I don't want to do too much detail in those areas because I know a lot of people like white fur, which again is very hard to achieve, and I'm just learning that maybe sometimes just leaving it white with a little bit of detail is better than nothing. So I'm going to add a little bit of cold gray too down here because it is a lot more shadow down here. And then just kind of bring it down like this. There we go. I don't know, can you guys start seeing like the details and how it's coming along? This is usually the part where I give up and say start again. I'm not liking it, but you gotta push past that and just keep going. Like they say in Nemo, just keep swimming. So I'm trying to get you in a good spot here so when I rotate it, it won't look funny. How about right there? Sun setting too, so the sun's right in my eye while I'm drawing. That is okay, we'll keep going. Alright, what color can I go with now? You know what, we'll risk it, we'll go in with dark sepia. Now I'm gonna take my time here because I really need to make sure to get the lines in the correct spot. So this kind of flicks up. I'm not using a hard pressure here. I'm definitely using a light pressure. This definitely curves back more. I believe the husky's looking up in this reference photo. So So while I'm doing this, anybody here watching this video have a favorite animal? You do have a favorite animal. Let me know down below. Maybe I can do an eye tutorial on that animal. It doesn't have to be a pet. It can be a wildlife animal. Any animal that you like, really. Always looking for different things to draw. Same with here. We're gonna just go over these pencil lines a bit. Being very loose with these pencil strokes, because I know they'll probably end up changing once I get more layers put down. Can I go on top of that? This one. Six. Warm gray six. Warm gray six. So I'm taking warm gray six, and I'm actually just going to darken up the areas where the fur meets together. So like right here, I know the fur meets there. Down a bit here, a bit there. And here as well. I'm using little flicks because the fur around the eye is actually a lot smaller than in the face. And I try to overlap my fur lines. Like snowflakes, no two are alike. Good, good. Okay, so I'm going to take this gray still, and I'm going to bring it down slightly here, because there's a few more defined strokes. on the fur down here. You can see. I'm not going too dark. I'm not putting a lot of pressure down. Just because I don't want the focus to go away from the eye itself. There's not a lot going on here. We'll look at a little bit more here as well. Might have to lighten this area up just a tad bit. That's it. Alright, that is what crafting knife is for. So a little bit over here too. A little bit more up here too. I jump all over the place while I'm drawing. I don't know about anybody else. Gray time. Actually, just recently fell in love with this color. I have no idea why, but I absolutely love it. I think I love this color, and probably dark sepia might be next. And then definitely light magenta. Light magenta has to be another one of my favorites, which I could probably put a little bit in here. It might maybe help everything even more. Might do that. Might throw some light magenta in here. This time last year, I overbooked myself with Christmas commissions, and this year I didn't want to do that, so I definitely put a limit on commissions this year, which I am very thankful for. Again, I do have a full-time job right now. I didn't have one last year because of the C word, so I'm thankful to have a full-time job again, but that definitely means that I don't have as much time as I did for drawing. So drawing has become, once again, my hobby. But I did just get the Art is My Career book, and I am soaking in the knowledge, because who knows what could happen in the future. I only have a contract job right now, so who knows what could happen. Just kind of putting this down a little bit back here, using the side of my pencil more. There we of start seeing it take shape. I think I'm gonna leave it like that, maybe. Do that a bit. Just kind of. Bring out my warm gray and cool gray too. Again, I'm gonna darken up some of these shadowed areas a bit, like right here. Just kind of blend out a bit these dark lines, just so they make sense. Together nicely. Okay, we'll just kind of a little bit of darker shadows here. But it was on the lighter side, but I guess not. Now that the sun's out of my eyes, I can kind of see it a little bit more clearly. This is a bit darker, especially down here too. Warm gray too now. Where am I gonna go? Right here. Going around the eye where I think the shadows need to just be darkened up a bit. I'm kind of glazing over them with this color. Some colors together, like down here. Okay. pencil needs to be sharpened just a tad bit. That's okay, we're almost finished. Almost done. Started this in the morning. And then warm gray one. Don't know if I said warm gray one for that color, but that color was cold gray one. Maybe. You know what? I'm gonna go in with this, I believe it was warm gray 6, and I'm just gonna add some fur lines down here, even though they're not in the reference photo, just so that way you can kind of see some fur details. I'm actually going to bring it up into there a bit too. Okay. Don't want to go too overboard with that color. Okay. I'm taking my ivory and my beige red again. So beige red. I'm just gonna kind of do a quick little glazing over these colors down here. Just so. And down there a bit too. And then we're gonna add a little bit of ivory as well, I think. Here. It's a little bit of a, I don't know, like a skin tone. I feel like these two colors can help. Kind of glaze it over these fur lines that I just did. Same with beige red, going in again with beige red and just a hint of this color. Fur here. And up here too. Nice. And we're gonna add a little bit of a salt and pepper look in this for a bit before going in with black. This is Payne's. No, this is Dark Sepia. This is Dark Sepia. Husky eyes definitely are gorgeous. Going in black now. Good old black. We're gonna definitely bring it out down here just a tad bit. And definitely down here too. Here as well. And up here. And here. Here too. Just a tiny. Darker right here as well. These fur strokes I'm being a little bit more loose with, as long as I'm going in the correct fur direction, I really am okay with how it turns out. Because my main focus is probably around this spot here. Like I said earlier in the video, I do have tutorials on other fur colors. So if you struggle with fur or anything like that, please do go check them out. I mean, I have my days too where I need to remind myself of how to do things. Cold gray, I think needs to, yeah, cold gray 6 needs to kind of help me out here a bit. And even right here a bit. Alrighty, going over it with cold gray 1. working with ivory and beige red just a little bit more. Kind of lost the color up here. And then just a little bit right here too, actually. I lost the color. Ivory. Going in with ivory to blend that out just a little bit. So before I go in with white, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my craft knife. I'm going to add just a little bit of detail with this. Be careful, sharp. I don't even want to rip the paper or anything, so. Thank you. last touch up right here in this area here with my beige red. And then I think I might be done. Actually, I'm gonna go in with my cold gray here. Now I'm going in with white. Just gonna kind of off camera, I'm actually cleaning the edge of the white just because I don't want the dark colors to blend in with the lighter areas. Do it. I'll just add a little bit of black lines here, real quick. I might have taken away just a tad too much with the knife, but that's okay. Just add some line details back in. There we go. I think. This is it. Sweet deal. Okay. Thank you for sticking it out until the end of this video. I hope this video helps you create your own realistic husky eye. If you haven't done so already, please leave a like and a comment down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Can you spot the little heart in the eye at all? Decided to throw a little something in there.